So he had this unusual combination. In one case, the mother cried her heart out, saying, look, I'm getting old, you better get married, who is going to do the cooking? And the boy got married, and then he started visiting Ramakrishna, and he said, look, if you wanted to visit Ramakrishna, why did you get married? And the boy said, no, I can't win here with this mother. So they had all sorts of unusual conflict in the family, unusual developments. But there was one, you know, one interesting incident I think we should mention is this. There was one particular disciple, young boy, I think I should make a big thing about him. His name was Subodh. Now this Subodh was a very guileless person, not very learned, could not speak English even, very simple boy, became very closely attached to Ramakrishna. And completely guileless. So whatever Ramakrishna said, he would swallow it and accept it without any difficulty, without any complication. But the story, the funny part I want to say is, because there was a lot of fun and games too. This Subodh later on became Swami Subodhananda, and he was called Khokha Maharaj. Khokha means a young boy. Now this Khokha Maharaj struggled, and then when Vivekananda became famous and all the American ladies started to visit, Khokha Maharaj was put in charge of giving them a guided tour. So, you know, he doesn't know English, and these American ladies are coming and he's giving them guided, this is Ganga, this is Dakshineshwar, and he's doing this, conducted tour. And then Vivekananda told him, look, at the end of the tour, these ladies will tell you, thank you. And there's one English word that your English response you must give. This is good, otherwise it's rude. Khokha Maharaj said, yes, what should I reply? When they say thank you say, I don't care. And this used to happen regularly, and all the ladies would get, you know, surprised, why is he talking like that? Thank you is, I don't care. This is, and they went away surprised. Khokha Maharaj was surprised, why are these ladies misbehaving like this? I just told exactly what Vivekananda said, I don't care. So this kind of, you see, look, why should I say, bring this in? Even though there was tremendous pressure, tremendous hard strife in the spiritual progress, there was tremendous humor. Remember this. Spirituality without humor becomes morbid, and it is downright denigrating. Spirit is full of life, full of humor. Without humor, you lost the plot.